And if we've told you before the competition that Victor and Brian were going to miss their combination and you were going to land yours, what would you have said?
Hey, stop pulling the leg. No,
I'm not pulling your leg. That's what happened.
No, I can't believe it. It's been a dream week so far for me.
If anybody has ever had any complaints about your skating, the only thing was he doesn't have a triple axel. Yeah. I've never seen you do it in competition before.
It's the first time ever.
Let's have a look at it. It looked easy.
Didn't feel easy.
Didn't feel easy? Tell me about it.
I just, the whole way through, I was just saying, okay, I'm just going to grit my teeth and just let it go. I believe I can do it. Everyone else has got the confidence to put it in there. So let's go for it. And it went.
Thanks, Stephen.
Thank you.
The unexpected results of the competition thus far this evening have given a real opportunity for the American champion, Scott Davis. But he must wait, because next to skate is the Canadian champion, Elvis Stojko, a most unusual young man, as Greg Gumbel discovered.
When you've been named after the king of rock and roll, you better have some stage presence. Sightings of Elvis may occur on a regular basis, but here it isn't Presley who looms larger than life. This is Elvis Stojko. When you see him working out on the heavy bag, you think he's a classy little welterweight. Then he cuts loose with a couple of kicks and you say, uh-oh, he's one of those guys.
I started out martial arts when I was 10 years old, and I got my black belt when I was 16.
That was in karate. This is kung fu, a martial art that allows him to stretch his 5'6" and discipline his mind and body for his real sport, figure skating.
Is there a tie between the two?
I think there is. Martial arts has really helped my skating in the mental state as well as the physical. I've seen martial arts done to music, and it's really cool. It's different. I like to put that on the ice and have a different side of skating instead of just the ballet side.
Stojko's mentor is David Stevenson, who teaches him his martial moves and lessons on living up to his name.
When I first started working with Elvis, I said to him, I want you to think like a king. I want you to think like you own the stadium. You own the ice.
He's already KO'd Kurt Browning to become the Canadian national champion. He's only 21. He has time, talent, and energy in his corner.
He is the current Canadian champion, 22 years of age, a combination martial arts exponent, dirt bike racer, and terrific figure skater. From Canada, Elvis Stojko. And as you have seen throughout the evening, there is plenty of room at the top.
Welcome to techno hip hop. Elvis Stojko is probably the best athlete in the event, and his opening combination is crucial. Triple-triple combination, the first being a triple axel. Triple axel, double toe loop, very smart. He was slow coming down in the triple axel. If he would have gone for the triple toe loop, he might not have made the rotation. Very intelligent move. called Element here, triple Lutz. Great footwork sequence here. This program, a combination spin, notice his speed, position of body is very important. He's delivered this program. This should get incredible marks.
Elvis Stojko has become the first of the five gold medal favorites to make it through this minefield called the technical program unscathed. Mom and Dad.
All week in practice, he started off a little slow, and then he just kept getting stronger every day. Look at the size of this triple axel, the tight air position. It's huge. A little grab on the toe there killed his momentum, so he had to do a double toe loop, but very intelligent move. Part of skating is performing. And Elvis can work a crowd.
Mom and Dad, Irene and Steven, clapping throughout.
I'm fine, thanks. Until Liz, Rico, Dave.
Yeah. Here are the first set of marks for Elvis Stojko.
5'8", 5'7". These represent his strength. He's probably the best athlete in the competition.
Hi, Michelle. Hi, Dustin.
Lucy Kessler is choreographer on the left, Doug Lee, his coach on the right. They wait for the second set of marks.
And these will probably go down. The judges are very conservative as far as Elvis is concerned, and they really kind of have been a little reluctant to give him the marks for this, but straight first all the way across the board.
Stojko goes into first. He is the Canadian champion, and right behind him,